What you're about to witness is one of the most sinister sounding intros to a trailer to one of the greatest epics ever produced. And there's more, because you are going to see it as well.
Yes, it.
Yes, it.
Well, it seems that way. Pukchung is where there was another missile launch about 1 month ago. The Joint Chiefs of Staff have already been in a meeting, and there is expected to be another enlarged emergency meeting that got underway about 10 minutes ago that also involves President Moon Jae-in trying to assess whether this was a successful or a failed launch, exactly what kind of missile. They haven't confirmed yet what it was, but we have heard some unconfirmed intelligence reports that it may have been a Taepodong-1 missile, which is a three-stage medium-range missile based on the older, a very primitive Scud missile, the sort that was used widely by Iraq during the first Gulf War. That in itself is interesting because it is not a long-range missile. It is not one of the missiles that would provoke tougher sanctions. So really the analysis right now, of course, is whether this is the DPRK putting pressure on, interested in talks, interested in what Seoul is talking about since the change of government, also China pushing back towards the negotiating table, but ensuring they're coming in with a strong negotiating hand, or just pushing on with these tests. But given that Kim Jong-un had been pledging to test longer-range missiles, the sort of missiles that might reach the United States, it does appear that this test and the last one were really tests that were designed to let be known that Pyongyang is still there and still advancing with its missile program, but not testing weapons big enough to invoke an immediate reaction that could see the United Nations Security Council coming together to push for tougher